UFC Fight Pass, guys, if you have friends that want to see MMA, I would say UFC Fight Pass right now. It's the easiest way to sign up.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the eternal middleweight division. Firstly, fighting out of our blue corner, this man weighed in at 84.15 kilos and a professional record of 4 fights and 3 victories. Training under Daniel Kelly, he fights out of the resilient gym in Melbourne. Please welcome Sebastian Temesi. His opponent in our red corner, he weighed in at 84.85 kilos, unbeaten in 3 professional bouts. Training under Alex Prates, he fights out of the Gracie Gym in Smeaton Grange, Sydney. Please welcome Jacob Mamba Malkoun.
So our fight MC, Dave Ella, getting us excited as always.
I wouldn't have rather lose my job to a better man. I did used to ring announce in Perth. Dave takes over now, but he's a, you know, smarter dresser and a better talker. Fight's about to kick off.
Better facial hair too.
Just better all around.
All right, here we go. Referee looking to clap us in. Fight number 2 this evening here, the middleweight division. And we are underway. Jacob Mamba Malkoun taking on Sebastian Temesi.
The best kept secret in MMA. We're going to start calling
stiff
him.
Jab there from Mamba. And 2 years out of the cage for Sebastian Temesi. Let's see if there's any hint of cage rust.
Beautiful stiff jab.
So the boys feeling things out here, exchanging jabs. The opening stages, low half kick there from Malkoun.
Now these are 84 kilo men. There are some power hands, power and kicks, so they're going to be feeling each other out, getting that range. Ooh.
He is slick. He is
so quick. Messi, not looking too afraid of those hands, of course.
So, of course, Mamba Malkoun, fresh off a victory in July of this year, got a TKO victory over Christopher Van Dyke. And like we mentioned earlier, Temesi, 2 years out of the cage almost, or slightly under, about 16 minutes. And a couple of cleaner shots landed there, some heavy leather exchanged from the Mamba.
Very much starting out as a boxing match, which you would have to say it's probably only in favour of Malkoun right now.
Yeah, going to be interesting to see if we see that judo black belt put to use from Sebastian Temesi. Worth noting too. Big right hand landed.
Nice head movement by Temesi, but he did get caught on that right, slipping to the left.
It's also worth noting, we do have Ben Sassoli in the corner of Sebastian Temesi. Big congratulations to Ben Sassoli, recently signed to the UFC and taking on the man pretty much every heavyweight wants to fight shortly.
I mean, right there.
Mr. Greg Hardy. So
everyone who's anyone, Eternal MMA tonight.
So congratulations out of Ben, and we wish him luck here from Eternal MMA and the broader Australian MMA scene. So 2 minutes gone in this one, and so far so good there for Mamba. And interesting, Mamba shooting for the takedown there.
I personally think that's a bit to keep him guessing, so he doesn't think it's all hands and kicks coming right now. He wants to, it is mixed martial arts, he does want to mix it up a bit. Who's going for the takedown will set up the hands and the kicks. Oh, beautiful right.
Sebastian Temesi showing off a chin here early in this one.
Definitely hurt him a little bit, but Temesi is tough as anything. Now, the beauty of fighting in this smaller, intimate venue is that your coaches can be heard. So a lot of the fighters turning off. Beautiful right hand again.
Yeah, looked like a stumble there. The legs momentarily giving out for Sebastian Temesi. Wings on the right hand.
Malkoun landing his shots, but getting out.
A really good sense of distance on display here from Mamba.
Temesi not shying away, though. Putting that pressure on.
Yeah, for how clean some of these big shots have landed, and we're all aware of the power that Mamba holds in his hands. Sebastian Temesi is eating them all pretty well.
Malkoun doing a really good job of mixing it up. When you get used to his hands, he's throwing some feet. You get used to it all, he's trolling those takedowns. Temesi just keeps coming forward.
So just under 2 minutes remaining here in the first round. We are in for 3 rounds on this middleweight bout.
Oh. Holy quick.
In and out once again there from Mamba.
Temesi is coming forward.
Touching with the lead hand and firing that right hand with some authority. Pretty impressed with how comfortable Sebastian Temesi is looking in there, considering the extensive layoff, not really showing too many issues as far as timing is concerned, and that's usually the thing that most people struggle with coming back after a long layoff.
And he has taken some shots early on in this round, but that has not stopped him from coming forward and still looking loose. He looks quite loose. He's not plodding forward or anything like that. Look at that. He's keeping his distance as well. He's getting caught with a couple from Malkoun, but look at those slips from Temesi. Oh, beautiful head kick.
Inside leg kick from Malkoun, and then countered with the lead high kick from Sebastian Temesi.
These boys are putting it on straight away.
So really enjoying that inside low kick, his Mamba. Ah, beautiful.
Temesi, great head movement. Okay, really looking to find that inside leg kick to set up.
Yeah, there it is. I was just about to call for that. When you do come up against someone who's getting a little fancy with the head movement, if you can finish those combinations with kicks or knees, sometimes you can catch the head out of position and lands up the flush. And we saw Mamba go oh so close to doing just that inside the final 10 seconds now.
Beautiful.
And here we go. Round number two. A big good evening to everyone joining us on the live webcast. Leave her on Facebook for the opening two fights. We are live here from the Melbourne Pavilion, Eternal MMA 48, and we are watching fight number two, the middleweight division, and a couple of big boys throwing some heavy leather. My name's Daniel Maudsley, and I'm joined in the booth with Mitchell Tinley.
Without a doubt, these boys starting to take off where they left off. Malkoun looking to be nice and loose with the hands, but Temesi just keeps coming forward, trying to figure him out, trying to find this angle where he can work this.
And of course, Sebastian Temesi, no stranger to going the distance. His last two wins over William Namoa and Dan Curry coming via unanimous decision. So he can go the three rounds if needed here.
Nice. Malkoun with that beautiful, picks his shots and gets it out without taking a scratch.
Yeah, that's been the story of the fight so far, hasn't it, Mitch? We've seen a really nice work as far as the range control is concerned with Jacob Malkoun.
I mean, when you do look at it like that, Temesi's taking some shots, he's landing some shots. Malkoun's landing some shots, he's not taking too many.
Nice right hand sticks again there from Mamba. That seems to be the weapon of choice here in this one. I must admit, ooh, I was expecting to see perhaps some more grappling from Sebastian Temesi, but perhaps that not part of the game plan like we were forecasting.
Malkoun feeling that jab out a little bit. Temesi starting to really pick his shots a little bit more. First round, he was coming out a little bit harder. Temesi now trying to play with that distance. He's standing off a little bit further, still with the great head movement.
Ooh. Big lead high kick lands.
And you got your wish, Daniel.
But there we go. We've got the grappling now. Sebastian Temesi just ate that thing like a pancake and straight down onto the mat.
And we're going to see this Malkoun ADCC trial. Now we're going to see this jiu-jitsu, see if he's going to work the jiu-jitsu or use it to get up.
So a little knee shield half guard here. Bit of front control. Nice work potentially hitting the switch there to get back to his feet, but goes back to controlling the head of Temesi.
Yeah. Temesi's looking like he's going to want to hold Malkoun down here.
So 2.5 minutes remaining, and this could be a really good opportunity here for Sebastian Temesi to start getting some control time on the board. But look at that. Nice work. Oh, guillotine attempt.
That looks pretty deep.
Hits beautifully there.
That does look pretty deep. Oh, he's popped out to the side. Oh, beautiful escape by Temesi.
Yeah, well done from Temesi there, getting his back onto the mat.
It is hard too. We went to round two. Both men are sweaty.
Great leather change. And look at this.
Malkoun enjoyed the grappling there. Would like to go straight back.
Anything you can do, I can do better, says Mamba. Onto the mat now, in closed guard. Nice strong overhook with the right arm there.
He's got 2 minutes to work on the body. He's going to really want to still soften this arm. It's not going to turn into a complete grappling match here. Well, of course, in mixed martial arts, he's dropping some hard elbows, Malkoun. Nice right hands. Temesi doesn't seem too phased there.
Sebastian Temesi has just a chin made of steel. He's been hit with some big shots and hasn't really looked too phased by any of it.
Nope. Tough as a year 12 exam. Temesi just... at least mine, anyway. Malkoun, looking at that, the mat too. Like it's a great surface, but it does have a little bit more slide than the usual canvas you might see in the UFC.
Yeah, it's interesting you bring that up because the current Eternal MMA Australian lightweight champion David Smiling Assassin Martinez is actually having a chat to his coach Ryan Dunstan about that, and that's something that Ryan says all coaches should do: go in and check the surface of the cage before their fighters go in and enter for their respective fights.
That's true.
So it's something a few people have noticed.
It's the same. It's like when you're on the street, it's gravel. Malkoun really looking to hold control back, because Temesi did get him down earlier, and in the eyes of the judges, that could maybe sneak you around, but Malkoun doesn't want to take...
Oh, beautiful pass here.
He doesn't want to take any risk if it does go to the judges. You want to make sure that he's dominated every round, and Temesi got that takedown earlier, so Malkoun wanted to at least spend more time on top.
Yeah, it was an interesting little switch up of the game plan here from Malkoun. But really enjoying the closing stages of this one is the corner in the red there.
I cannot get over how durable Temesi is. His shots just do not faze him. And Malkoun is throwing hard.
Yeah, never been finished in his professional career, Sebastian Temesi.
I don't see that changing, but Malkoun is trying to do just that. He's dropping some elbows, some hammer fists. About 5 seconds remaining. Really wants to put a stamp on this round two. Heading into the final round.
Came into that fight as a gigantic underdog and toughed his way through a couple of tough first rounds and came back with a third round TKO. Can we see his student, Sebastian Temesi, put on something similar here, Mitch?
Temesi, he's going to want to look to...
Oop. Nice timing there, but good sprawl from Temesi.
We did talk about the surface earlier. When it does get a little sweaty, you can get a bit of that slip going on. Beautiful canvas, though.
And even more beautiful now with that UFC Fight Pass logo on there.
Oh, gotta love that. Might have a lot of new viewers just checking Eternal MMA out for the very first time. Head up on Facebook, Eternal MMA, to find out more there. YouTube as well to find some old fights, especially some of the ones we're talking about. Malkoun in the center, putting a bit of that pressure on. Temesi backed up against the cage. Temesi's looking really good with that range. He's starting to really hit and not get hit now.
Well, we have been talking about the layoff, potentially that just affecting his range perception here in the opening couple of rounds, but very fun fight regardless. Both these boys have stood in the pocket and exchanged for a majority of it.
You can tell Malkoun goes full into boxing mode sometimes. He lands a couple and he goes, yep, I'm gonna tee off like it's a heavy bag. And you can just see those boxing credentials.
I like the way he's pouring with that lead jab.
Loves it. Like exactly what you said, Dan.
Straight into the head on the outside single leg and rips him down. So into top half guard now, we have the Mamba, Sebastian Temesi, with some work to do.
Yes.
3.5 minutes to go in this one. And, well, you've got to imagine it's 3.5 minutes for Sebastian Temesi to try and get some pretty substantial offense off if he wants to get a victory here.
He's going to just lock him up right now. Perhaps to stop the elbows raining down and take that space away, because he's going to try and create the space. Malkoun's going to land those strikes. Temesi wants to eliminate that space.
So currently got the overhook with the right arm there. If he wants to look to try and get back to his feet, probably should be trying to dig for an underhook with that right arm. Gives him a few more sweep options and a few more options as far as getting back to his feet are concerned. In half guard, it's really difficult to get any sort of offense going off with your hips and shoulders flat on the mat.
Now, with Malkoun too, knowing that his hand was tied up, he's dropping those short, sharp little elbows, and he's still keeping that pressure on. He doesn't want to give any space, because like we said, they are sweaty. Temesi might use that to get some space and the sweat to slide off and get back to his feet.
So halfway through the final round now, 2.5 minutes still to go. And on top here, in half guard, is Mamba Jacob Malkoun.
Temesi really trying to turn into that.
So on cue, we're hearing Dan Kelly screaming for Sebastian to start digging for that underhook.
He's looking to really just tie up Malkoun there in those spots. He does not like those elbows at all, while he can figure out what he wants to do grappling-wise.
Oh, beautiful control there from Mamba. Did a great job just avoiding that underhook attempt from Sebastian.
He's going for a bit of a lockdown, Temesi. And he's out of it. Oh, Malkoun slides into the
here. And potentially looking for the back. Nice work with the control. And hooks in.
Oh, that is more of a face crush over the top of the face, but that can still be finished in that position. You don't need to be fully under the chin.
Not quite.
But after nearly three rounds, you are tired, and it does put a lot of stress to crush a human's face.
So here we go, a minute remaining, and can Jacob Mamba Malkoun put the finishing touches on what's been a dominant performance so far?
Messi
to the turtle position. Oh, some big shots landed.
Oh, beautiful switch out. Back to his feet to Messi.
So Sebastian to Messi just showing
nice.
Off a chin of granite.
Stuffs that takedown attempt by Malkoun. Still got beautiful head movement. Malkoun starting to find a home for those hands.
Nice fake upstairs to the head on the outside single leg attempt, but we are seeing Sebastian Temesi digging for that underhook.
Breaks away.
Good body shot on the exit there from Mamba.
Nice shots by Temesi. That's more of a slip there. There's definitely more of a slip. But either way, Malkoun is back on top. Starting to rain some damage down. Temesi looking to just tie him up as we finish the rounds.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for these two fighters. We go to the judges' scorecards. The judges score this fight after three rounds, 30-26, 30-27, 30-27, all for the winner by unanimous decision in the red corner, Jacob Malkoun.
So your winner by unanimous decision, now moving to 4-0 as a professional, Jacob Mamba Malkoun. And it looks like our
ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with the winner of this fight, Jacob Malkoun. Jacob, that now takes your record to four fights, four victories. Just a little bit on that fight. He seemed a little bit more elusive than what he looked. He had his hands down a lot. He dropped the head down to knee height. He just seemed a little bit hard to tag. How did you find it?
I performed to the best that I can. I know that.
What do you think that was tonight?
I don't know. Sometimes you have them nights. Me, when I win and I do a good performance, I'm upset. So I win now, not that good. So I'm probably going to be more upset. But I don't know, maybe expect too much of yourself.
Well, at the end of the day, the win is the win. Yeah, you'd love to do better, but it does take your record to 4-0. And you've got a fantastic corner behind you. I'm sure you'd like to thank some of those guys.
I'd like to thank Justin Fitzgerald from Stand Strong Boxing, from Alex Prates, our pretty much grappling coach, and more. Everyone, all the coaches are more than what they do. Fab, Ite, is our everything. Wrestling, performance coach, fitness. I'd like to thank Justin Lane for getting my fitness back up to where it should be. Obviously, I can get a lot better, but all good.
Fantastic, Jake. Great to have you. Fantastic on the win. Ladies and gentlemen, a man to watch in the middleweight division, Jacob Malkoun.
So there we have it. One of the hottest prospects in Australian MMA.